वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस मॉड्यूल वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ ओवर सब्सक्रिप्शन एंड हाउ द कंपनी इज गोइंग टू डील ए सिचुएशन ऑफ ओवर सब्सक्रिप्शन एंड वी हैव मेंशन दैट देर आर 3 to 4 ऑल्टरनेटिव्स इन विच द कंपनी विल टेक वन ऑफ द ऑल्टरनेटिव टू डील विद द ओवर सब्सक्रिप्शन एंड As per this module, we will be dealing 3 alternatives. In some texts, it will be 4 alternatives. But in 3 alternatives, we will be covering all those 4 alternatives that are mentioned in some of the other texts. So let us continue with the concept. We have discussed about the one of the first alternative a company will select in order to deal with a oversubscription, where the company will accept some applicants or applications in full and totally reject the others. That means whenever there is an excess applications, all such excess will be rejected. Rejected means the amount will be refunded to the subscribers. So let us go to the next one, pro rata distribution. Second alternative, pro rata allotment, or in simple terms we can say ratio allotment, like that. So this is the most commonly used alternative by a company whenever they have to deal with a situation of oversubscription. So how it's dealt by the company? The directors can make a proportionate distribution of shares available for allotment among the applicants of four shares. In such a situation, all the applicants get the allotment but a lesser number of shares than they have applied for. This will be arrived at by the ratio which the number of shares to be allotted bear to the number of shares applied. Remember, number of shares allotted by number of shares applied. That is the ratio. In every case, if the company follow a pro rata allotment, the shares will be allotted to those applications or applicants on the pro rata basis. Pro rata basis means on a certain ratio, and the ratio is computed by the equation shares allotted divided by shares applied. That is the equation for the ratio. This is called pro rata or proportionate or partial allotment. So actually, in the first method, we will be rejecting all the excess. But in case of pro rata allotment, here instead of rejecting the excess, the company will make necessary arrangements to issue a part of their applicant or application. That is, if 5,000 are applied by the subscribers, the company will make a certain ratio and the company will allot 3,000 instead of rejecting that entire 5,000. That is the principle. So how they are rejecting the excess money, or how they are rejecting the excess application? That is on the basis of a certain ratio, and the ratio is computed by the equation shares allotted divided by shares applied. On the basis of this ratio, or otherwise known as pro rata or proportionate, this on the basis of this proportionate ratio, shares are allotted. And any excess application or subscriptions, after adjusting these pro rata basis, that amount will be refunded or rejected. In this case, excess application money, or the application money on shares applied for but not allotted, may be retained for its utilization towards the amount due on allotment. If it still exceeds the excess amount, may be transferred to calls in advance account to be adjusted when calls are made. That is a usual concept. So let us discuss the same with an example, then you will get a clear picture regarding that. If a company receives application for 20,000 shares, but actually company issues only 10,000 shares of in hand. So out of 10,000 issued, the public has subscribed for, or 20,000 shares or 20,000 subscribers were applied for the shares. That is an excess of 10,000. The company can allot only 10,000 because in hand they have only 10,000 shares. And as per this pro rata allotment, to all the applicants to whom the shares were applied, in that case, the ratio of allotment will be done on the basis of pro rata basis, that is, shares allotted divided by applied. Allotted means actual number of shares held by the company, that is meant by allotted. So 10,000 is the number of shares held. Only then these shares can be allotted to the public. The company can't offer anything more than that. So allotment or shares to be allotted divided by applied, that is 1/2. That means one share would be allotted to the applicants who have applied for two shares. So instead of rejecting all the excess, here the shares are allotted in a pro rata basis or on a ratio basis, and the ratio is computed on the basis of the equation allotted divided by applied, and this on the basis of this ratio shares are allotted to the subscribers, and any excess amount received will be adjusted in the allotment or first call or second call, like that. But in usual cases, any excess will be allotted in the allotment, because excess will be received in the case of application or applying first installment, and it will be adjusted in the subsequent installment, that is allotted or allotment. Let us discuss a case, then you will get a clear picture. A limited company invited application for 1 lakh equity shares of rupees 10 each, payable on application rupees 2 per share, allotment rupees 3 per share, first call rupees 2 per share, and 2 months after allotment. So remember, here the 2 months after the allotment, first call is made, and second and final call of rupees 3, and it is made after 2 months after the first call. Dates may be specified because you need to mention the actual dates of each of these installments in the respective date column of the journal. So remember that. Applications were received for 2 lakh shares. Actually, company has only 1 lakh shares, or company issued only 1 lakh shares on 1st January 2010. Allotment was made on 1st February 2019. So the dates, make sure the dates are correct. First one is January 2019, and allotment was made on 1st February 2019. The director decided to make a pro rata allotment of 50% of the shares applied for by every applicant to apply the balances of application money towards the amount due on allotment and to refund the amount remaining thereafter. Pass entries assuming that allotment and call monies were received within 15 days of making allotment and calls. Here the dates and number of days is specified in order to record the journals on the exact days. So whenever you pass the entries with regard to an allotment and call money, make sure to leave a 15 days gap between these two entries, because it is mentioned in the question. Otherwise, we need not have to worry about that. Okay. Here, 1 lakh shares were issued by the concern. Company received 2 lakhs. So it is a situation of oversubscription. And the company can choose any of the three alternatives. And in this question, it is mentioned that the company has to select pro rata allotment. So on the basis of pro rata allotment, there is a ratio will be given. In this question, the directors decide to make a pro rata allotment of 50% of the shares applied for by every applicant. That is, 50% may be allotted to the applicants, and the excess amount will be adjusted in the allotment. So to apply the balances of application money towards amount due on allotment and to refund the amount remaining thereafter. So any excess amount will be adjusted in the allotment, and even after there is any surplus amount after adjusting in the allotment installment, that excess will be refunded. So that is the concept. Actually, in this case, we need not have to worry about the refund situation, because there is no information regarding how much amount has to be refunded. The only information given in the question is you need to adjust the excess amount of application in allotment. So how we are going to find the excess amount? Because in the question already given, only 50% of the applications should be adjusted in the application installment or at the time of first installment, and the excess 50,000 should be adjusted in the subsequent installment, otherwise known as allotment. So in this question directly given the ratio, and because percentage is directly given, sometimes it may not be given, so you need to find the percentage or the ratio. Even if the 50% is not given, we can easily find out, because your total allotted or the shares going to be allotted are 1 lakh and shares applied is 2 lakhs. So the equation for the finding out the ratio or percentage is 1 lakh divided by 2 lakh, that is 1/2. 1/2 means 50%. See, if this 50% was not given, you can easily identify the ratio for pro rata basis. I hope you are getting the concept. Okay, let us prepare the journal entries. First of all, journal. I believe you all know the format of a journal: date, particulars, ledger folio, debit and credit. And remember the dates specified in the question. Application were received for 2 lakh shares on 1st January 2019. So let us write down the first one. So whenever the application money is received, bank account debited to share application. So 2019 January 1, bank account debited to equity share application. So writing down the amount is another important aspect. Application of rupees 2 per share. How many shares were issued by the company? 1 lakh. So don't go directly into 2 into 1 lakh, 2 lakh, don't go like that, because actually 1 lakh may be issued by the company, I agree, but the company received the application money for 2 lakh shares. So in this entry you need to show the actual amount received by the company. So actual amount received means rupees 2 on 2 lakh shares. So 2 lakh into 2, 4 lakhs. Being application money received on applications for 2 lakh shares at rupees 2 per share. So once the payment entry is received, you have to pass the due entry. And what is the date for the due entry? It should be the date of the second installment. So second installment is allotment, and what is the date of the allotment? Allotment was made on 1st February. So let us take this date for passing the due entry with regard to share application. So February 1, equity share application account debtor 4 lakhs, because with regard to application we received 4 lakhs. But in this entry we are actually going to allocate the amount or shares with regard to the company's policy. Company's policy means as per the pro rata basis. So the directors decide to make a pro rata allotment of 50% of shares applied for every applicant. How much was the amount received by the company by way of application? 4 lakhs. Out of 4 lakhs, 50% should be allotted at that time, and excess amount should be adjusted in the next installment. Next installment means after application S1 is allotment. So out of 4 lakhs, the company is going to transfer only 50% as part of share application to the concerned equity share capital account, 2 lakhs. So what is the excess amount? Out of 4 lakhs, 2 lakhs is transferred to share capital and excess is 2 lakhs, and it is going to be adjusted along with the next installment, that is share allotment. So to equity share allotment, 2 lakhs. being the transfer of application money on shares allotted 1 lakh, because it is mentioned allotment of 50% of shares applied. Applied shares was 2 lakh shares. 50% of 2 lakhs is 1 lakh. And excess application money out of 2 lakh, 1 lakh is transferred to the respective share capital. Then the remaining 1 lakh is transferred to the share allotment account. So 1 lakh into 2, because application value was 2. Don't worry about the allotment. Whenever you transfer the allot to the excess amount to the allotment account, whether you have to consider this amount, no need to worry about, because this 3 per share will be considered only at the time of second installment. Here we are dealing with the first installment, so we haven't reached to the second installment. So we will transfer the value or the excess amount to the allotment as per the value of application per share. So 1 lakh into 2, 2 lakhs adjusted against allotment money due. So in simple sense, as per the company's rule, 50% will be allotted to the share capital and the excess amount will be transferred to the next installment. So 50% is 2 lakhs to the equity share capital and remaining 2 lakhs to the equity share allotment account. So next one, you need to pass the entries with regard to the second installment, that is allotment, and the date is 1st February 2019. Equity share allotment account up to equity share capital. Allotment value is rupees 3 per share. So from here onwards, you have to deal with 1 lakh shares, because from each of the installments which we are going to deal with, the company is going to allot or make necessary adjustments on the basis of number of shares issued. And don't worry anything about number of shares received or applied for. So in the second case, on allotment amount entries, equity share allotment account up to equity share capital, total number of shares is 1 lakh. 1 lakh into 3, 3 lakhs. So we being allotment money due on 1 lakh shares at rupees 3 per share. We have passed the due entry. Next is the payment entry. And with regard to payment entry, you have to be very cautious regarding the date of each of these entries, because in the sentence last part of the question, pass entries assuming that allotment and call money were received within 15 days of making allotment and calls. So we have made the entry or we have passed a due entry with regard to allotment. So the payment will be received within 15 days. So on 1st February we have passed the due entry, so on 15th February we will receive the payment entry. So on February 15th, bank account up to equity share allotment, rupees 1 lakh. So in the previous entry we have returned 3 lakhs. Now we have returned 1 lakh. Why we have returned 1 lakh? The thing is, at the time of application, we have allotted only 50% towards the share capital, and the other 50% is adjusted towards the next installment. Next installment means equity share allotment. So there is an amount of 2 lakh that is kept as a part of allotment, equity share allotment. So the company has to receive rupees 3 lakh in the form of allotment, but the company already set aside rupees 2 lakh which was received at the time of application towards allotment. So out of 3 lakh we have already received 2 lakhs. So the company need to collect only the remaining amount, that is rupees 1 lakh. This is the concept of prorata basis. Prorata actually works in this form. First of all, you need to divide or you need to allot the shares as per the ratio mentioned in the question. After that, you need to make the necessary adjustment with regard to the subsequent installments where the excess amount has to be dealt with. See, Here 2 lakh was the excess amount and it was transferred to the equity share allotment. And by way of equity share allotment, the company has to collect 3 lakhs. But already a 2 lakh amount has been set aside in the first installment itself. So the company need to collect only 1 lakh remaining part of the allotment installment. So being allotment money received after adjustment for excess application money. I hope you are getting the concept. The concept is very simple. Any excess amount received or adjusted in the application installment or application time will be adjusted in the allotment. So at the time of allotment, the company need not have to collect all the amount of the allotment. The company have to worry about the remaining portion of amount after adjusting the excess amount received or set aside at the time of application. That is the important concept with regard to prorata. The important aspect of prorata is finding out the ratio and how we are going to allot the excess amount received. After that, the next important thing you have to consider is how much amount should be collected or shown after adjusting the excess amount. Only these two aspects has to be considered at the time of prorata if the company is following the second alternative. We will discuss about that advanced cases in the next alternative. Right now, you need to understand only this much. I hope you understand the concept of rupees 1 lakh. So, entries with regard to allotment is over. Next one, you need to pass the entry with regard to first call. First entry is equity share first call account up to equity share capital account. And I hope you understand the concept of April 1 because it is mentioned in the question 2 months after allotment. So 2 months after February 1st is April 1. So equity share first call account up to equity share capital. Here the value of first call is 2 per share. Number of shares issued is 1 lakh. So 2 into 1 lakh, 2 lakhs. B first call money due on 1 lakh shares at rupees 2 per share. So we have passed the due entry. Next means you need to pass the payment entry and remember to enter the dates correctly as per the specification given in the question. 15 days after making the allotment and calls. So 15 days after the call is April 15, bank account up to equity share first call, same amount. From here onwards, you need not have to worry about anything or with regard to amounts because there are no allotment adjustments or allotments with regard to each of these installments. So next one, being call money received on 1 lakh shares at rupees 2 per share. Next one, second and final call of rupees 3 per share, that is 2 months after first call. So 2 months after April 1 is June 1st. Entry equity share second and final call account up to equity share capital. Value of second and final call is 3 per share. Total number of shares issued by the company is 1 lakh. So 3 into 1 lakh, 3 lakhs. Being first call money due on 1 lakh shares at rupees 3. Next is the payment entry. And remember to note the dates correctly. 15 days after the call is made. So 15 days after the call is June 15. Entry is bank account up to equity share second and final call. Amount is same since there is no adjustments or any calls in arrears or calls in advance with regard to the installment, that is with regard to these call monies. Just pass the general entries as usual. So these are the entries with regard to a case when the company has to deal with an oversubscription, whereby if the company is choosing the second alternative. I hope you have understand the concept. And you will be dealing with a question where instead of this ratio, details will be given, that is the company is following prorata, and on the basis of shares issued and applied for, you need to find this ratio. The concept is very simple. Go through the question very wisely. Identify the ratio or the percentage in which the shares are allotted at the time of application. Any excess has to be adjusted in the subsequent installment, that is allotment. And at the time of receipt of amount from the allotment, you need to adjust the excess amount which was adjusted at the time of application. That is a concept that we have to consider while dealing with this type of questions. Actually, these cases are very easy compared to the case which we are going to discuss in the next sessions. I hope you have understand the concept which we have discussed today. So just go through this. If you have any queries, please let me know. We will discuss about the next alternative in the coming sessions. Thank you.